Hello, and welcome to the commissioning and maintenance learning video for the Cerberus FIT fire detection system. In this lesson, we will explain the commissioning and maintenance of a Cerberus FIT system. We will show you the different configuration and commissioning steps. We will show you how to maintain the Cerberus FIT system. And finally, we will have a look at the additional documentation which is currently available. Let's get started. The commissioning of the FC360 is done with the online tool FC360 Panel Configurator. The panel has an integrated web server that can be accessed with a web browser. No additional software is needed. The FC360 Panel Configurator is mainly used to backup, modify, and apply the configuration of the fire control panel. In order to access the panel configurator, open a web browser and enter fc360.siemens.com or the IP address in the address bar. The default IP address is 192.168.251.100. For a firmware update, an offset configuration, or practicing configuration steps, use the FC360 desktop editor. Install and open the desktop editor software on a computer which is connected to the Cerberus FIT panel. Download the software using the link below this video. In general, both tools can be used to modify customer texts, properties and parameter settings, allocation of devices and zones, or control logics. For the commissioning of the Cerberus FIT FC360, further aspects have to be taken into account. As a start, the firewall settings need to be adapted if you would like to update the panel with your computer. For this, make sure to have admin rights on your PC. The first step is to search for the local security policy on the Windows start screen. Go to the Network List Manager policies and click on Unidentified Networks. Then, open the properties with a right click and check if the location type is set to private. Go on with the identifying networks and make sure that the location type in the properties is also set to private. Then, go to Windows Defender Firewall with Advanced Security. Expand the menu and the submenu and click right on Inbound Rules. Select New Rule to launch the wizard for new inbound rules. Select Program on the first page. On the Program page, click on Browse to go to the program path of your FC360 desktop editor installation. The default program path is on the C drive in the Program Files folder, as it is shown here. On the Action page, confirm the default setting Allow the Connection and go on to the Profile page. On this page, select the appropriate profile. In this case, it means to remove the checkbox for Domain, but the checkboxes for Private and Public have to be ticked. Click on Next and enter a specific name for the rule. Press Finish to close the wizard and check whether the new rule has been added to the list of inbound rules. Then, there are some additional settings which need to be done. In order to make sure that the rule is appropriately set, click right on the rule and select Properties. Go to the General tab and verify that the Enable checkbox for General and the Allow the Connection checkbox for Action have both been selected. In the Protocol and Ports tab, select UDP for the protocol type, specific ports for the local port with the value 69, and all ports for the remote port. Confirm the selections to enable the new firewall inbound rule and connect the panel and the PC. The panel firmware should be kept up to date. In order to initiate the update, make sure to have the latest version of the FC360 desktop editor installed. Verify if the firewall rules are set correctly and connect the panel to the PC. Open the desktop editor and click on the Update Firmware button. Then, set the panel to Access Level 3 and confirm the pop-up message. The firmware will now be updated. A message will be displayed to indicate if the update has been completed successfully. Next, let's take a look at the auto-configuration of the panel. Power up the panel and deactivate the buzzer with the switch S3. The panel will start up and you will be asked to select your country. To do so, navigate with the arrow keys and confirm your selection with OK. Next, select your language by also navigating with the arrow keys. Confirm your selection with OK. Then, decide whether the auto-configuration should be carried out during the startup process. If yes, confirm with the OK button to start the auto-configuration. All devices on the loops or stubs are read in and assigned to zones. If you would like to carry out the auto-configuration manually at a later time, press the C button. For the manual start of the auto-configuration, open the main menu and log in with Access Level 3 using the default pin 4x9. Then select Engineering and Detector Line. Navigate to Auto Configuration and confirm with the OK button. For security reasons, the default pin should be changed. Select the Engineering tab, go to Edit Name and Password, select Passwords, and select the user. Then enter the new password twice and confirm it with OK. Repeat these steps for all other access levels. Finally, make sure to switch the buzzer on again at the end of the day. For the modification of detection and control, open the online editor FC360 panel configurator with the default IP address 192.168.251.100 in your browser. Log in with the password, and as the starting page opens up, the connection to the panel has been established. Under Detection and Control, it is possible to modify the device number, change the type, add or change the device text, as well as making changes in the zone assignment and zone information. In the Element Properties tab, the settings can be adjusted for each element, for example the sensitivity of the detector, or when the connected alarm indicator should be activated. Please note that some devices offer only one parameter set, which cannot be changed. The definition of the output and sounder activations is done in the Cause and Effect tab. On this page, you can define which output or sounder should be activated by which device or event. Add a cause by selecting the event or add single detectors to an output or sounder. In order to backup the panel configuration, open the FC360 panel configurator and select the Backup button. Confirm the message and select the backup mode. The backup file will then automatically be downloaded to your computer. The file can be opened and changed in the desktop editor. If you would like to apply an existing configuration to your panel, use the Open button of the panel configurator to search for configuration files on your computer. The panel is equipped with a reminder function, providing information on the maintenance service. The intervals vary according to local regulations. The reminder can be set in the panel configurator. Another important maintenance aspect is the function test. This test must be carried out on a regular basis according to local regulations. The test must include all units connected to the panel. Test the CNET line by activating the detectors of each line and check them for dirt and dust. It is also possible to trigger a short circuit or open line. Verify the inputs and outputs by checking the controls and inputs of the application. Make sure to monitor the alarm organization and the RT transmission by triggering an alarm manually. Last but not least, examine all the functions of the panel itself. That includes the buttons, date and time, LEDs and display, earth connections, as well as the battery condition. Maintenance also includes a device test. For the smoke detectors, use an RE6 gas detector tester to test the functionality. For the functionality test of heat detectors, use an RE6T heat detector tester. The manual call points can be tested with the test key or by removing the cover and pushing the button. This depends on the model in use. Proceed as follows to ensure the proper operation of the CNET units. Enable the test mode on the device line, put the tester in place, and activate it to trigger an alarm. Confirm it and wait until the indication is off again. Finalize the process by setting the line to normal operation mode again. Let's see how it works on the panel. First, log in and open the main menu. Navigate to Operation and select Test. Then select Detection and choose if the detection test mode should be silent or audible. Select the line and the zone and confirm the activation of the zone test by selecting Yes. The test of the devices installed in the zone can now be started. Refer to the steps described before to exit the test mode after testing has been completed. The test report listing all tested devices can be downloaded in the Administration tab of the panel configurator. For the factory reset of the panel, open the menu on the FC360 panel and navigate to the Engineering option. Confirm with OK. Then, go to Factory Reset and confirm with OK. Press OK again to start the factory reset. All data will be deleted from the panel and the panel starts up again. When the restart has been completed, you can select if the auto configuration should be done now or at a later time. For further documentation, information and guidance, go to the Help section of the FC360 desktop editor or follow the link below this video. This was the last chapter of the Cerberus FIT Learning videos. Complete the following test to obtain your certificate.